What's new in accessibility at Google?
Hi everyone, it's Laura Allen again, back with another episode of What's New in Google Accessibility. We've got a lot of ground to cover, so let's get into it. Starting with Live Transcribe, an Android feature that people across the world can use to get real-time transcriptions of speech and sounds around them. With Live Transcribe, people with hearing loss can benefit from real-time transcripts on their phones. You can also use the app to type responses that can be read aloud rather than speak them, whether you have a speech impairment or just prefer using text-to-speech. And now, Pixel 9 Pro and other foldable phones can use Live Transcribe in dual-screen mode. Users can position their phones on a tabletop to display real-time transcriptions of conversations, making it ideal for meetings or social gatherings. On Android, we've also made hearing aid experiences more accessible. Using new LE audio technology, we're using the latest standards to decrease latency and give people faster access to hearing aid controls so they can customize their listening experience with presets for whatever environment they're in. And with AuraCast, currently on Samsung devices and in beta on Android 16, people can connect LE audio-compatible hearing aids directly to public broadcasts, like airport announcements, concerts, and more, without needing extra equipment. We've also introduced several improvements to TalkBack, Google's screen reader included on Android devices that gives people eyes-free control of their device. In TalkBack, people can now use Gemini, Google's AI-powered assistant, to have images described in more detail or get answers to follow-up questions. People using Pixel or Samsung devices can access this feature even when they're offline, in airplane mode, or in places where there's no internet connection. The latest version introduces new audio cues designed to enhance link activation and screen search capabilities, and offers expanded reading control, particularly when browsing the web. Moving on to Pixel updates, we're excited to announce the launch of Simple View, a feature that lets people navigate their devices more easily by increasing the display and font size, boosting touch sensitivity, and simplifying controls. Simple View also provides a more intuitive home screen layout, so important apps like contacts, weather, and photos are just a tap away. In Chrome news, Chrome on Android now offers Page Zoom for web browsing on mobile. This lets people with low vision and large web content, including text, images, video, and more, while keeping the page layout intact, just like on desktop. Chrome users will also be able to take advantage of Read Aloud, a browser feature in reading mode that reads entire web pages, articles, or documents aloud with natural-sounding voices.
Help every student learn how they learn best.
Read Aloud can be especially helpful for individuals who want to consume written content as audio, but aren't using a screen reader or select-to-speak on their device. Another thing we're excited to talk about is Chrome OS Face Control. This feature helps people with motor impairments control their device with facial gestures. Whether someone is online shopping or reading email, this feature allows them to experience hands-free web browsing and text selection. You can learn more about face control and Chromebook accessibility in a blog article linked in the video description. Next up, live captions in Google Meet. As a quick reminder, Google Meet allows people to access automated captions in several languages. Up until recently, meeting captions were only displayed in real time, but with the latest update, users can now scroll back in a conversation and review the last 30 minutes of captions. This is particularly helpful for anyone who's missed a portion of a conversation or wants to revisit specific details that were mentioned earlier. For Workspace users, we recently published 5 new Help Center articles about navigating apps like Chat, Docs, and Drive. These can be found at the link g.co/workspace/accessibility. And for screen reader users, we recently added new settings for Google Meet Reactions so people can better customize the meeting experience to their needs. New screen reader reaction settings include don't announce reactions, play a sound for all reactions, announce the reactions by saying the emoji, and announce all reactions and senders. We've also refreshed the look and feel of Google Calendar to include more convenient controls, such as buttons and sidebars, updated typefaces, and more modernized iconography. These changes are intended to improve the overall user experience. And finally, calendar users will now have the ability to toggle between light mode, dark mode, or their device's default theme options, providing a more comfortable and personalized viewing experience. That wraps up this episode of What's New in Google Accessibility. Thanks so much for tuning in. For more details, be sure to check out our YouTube video description, where we've added links and additional information about many of these updates. If you want to learn more, sign up for our newsletter at g.co/a11y/news or by clicking the link in the description of this video. Until next time.
What's new in accessibility at Google?